Well, good morning and welcome to worship. We are so excited that it's raining and not snowing. I mean, that's just my personal choice. Being from Florida, we really don't want snow ever. Except on Christmas Day, get the grass and then go away by that afternoon. That's just the perfect kind of snow for me. But today is a different kind of day as we celebrate through all different forms of music and different instrumentation. And so a lot of times it feels like it's just a performance. What you get in worship is what you put into worship. And so today, as you see the different gifts and the different talents taking place, realize that God has given those gifts. He's given us this opportunity to worship Him in so many different ways. And so allow yourself to worship as you see them worshiping. Because the songs they sing, the music they play, is an opportunity to relay to God once again that we do really come and adore Him. So as we continue to celebrate this Advent season, Brack and Laney are going to come and lead us.
Good morning. Unto us is born a Savior, Christ the Lord. This is good news of great joy. The candle we light today is the candle of joy, reminding us of the joy our Savior brings through life everlasting. Matthew 1:21 says, "You shall call his name Jesus, for it is he who will save his people from their sins."
Oh God, thank you for the daily gift of your Son, Jesus. We cannot praise you enough. Let my joy shine forth so that those cloaked by sadness may find their sorrow lifted. I ask this for the sake of your glory, in your name. Amen.
Thank you. stable on that Bethlehem morn, the Savior of the world was born.
Well, you're no spring chicken. That was the very first thing my neighbor said when I told her I was pregnant. Can you believe it? Maybe she just didn't believe me, but I don't hold it against her. She's been a tad cranky ever since she found a scorpion in her girdle drawer. Maybe she couldn't understand how much of a miracle this was for me. Zachariah and I, we tried our whole lives to have a child of our own. By the time most of my hair had turned gray and Zachariah's had turned loose, we had given up hope. But nothing is impossible with God. He seems to delight in making life in impossibly barren places. And if that wasn't enough, the angel who brought this unbelievable news had more to say. This child, our son, would be used by God to prepare our people for the coming of the Messiah. It was all too much of a gift to be real. And then I thought, how would we even begin to train a child for a job like that? But God had those details covered too, and it kept getting better. When I was about 6 months along, my cousin Mary came for a visit. No sooner had she said hello than my unborn son jumped and flipped inside of me. Right then, God opened my eyes to clearly see this young girl standing in our home was also with child, and he would be called Wonderful Counselor, Almighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. 9 months later, we got the news from Bethlehem, and I looked over at Zechariah holding our very own miracle baby. And I had one of those God moments, that moment when you realize that God had different plans. He had brought us life to barren places. He hadn't forgotten about us, and he would never leave us alone again.
Grateful chorus swell, the grateful chorus.
As long as I could remember, we'd been waiting for the Messiah to come for us. It's just always been that way. I always knew he'd come, but, well, let's be honest, it's not like I'm from Jerusalem or someplace special. I'm just a girl, a nobody from Nazareth. Everybody knows not much good comes out of Nazareth. Never has. I thought for sure that the angel had come to the house, had come to the wrong house with his announcement. But if this was what God wanted, then who was I to tell him he was wrong? And Joseph, oh God, bless that wonderful man. He could have joined in with everyone else, sent me away, even had me killed. But he never broke his promise to marry me. So when I went to Bethlehem for the census, I was honored to ride at his side, even with heartburn, bloated kegels, and 9 months of pregnancy behind me. You know those pregnant women who try different things to induce labor, like taking frequent walks or eating spicy foods? What they should do is set out on a bumpy 70-mile trip to Bethlehem, because not long after we arrived, well, I'd never done this myself, but I knew it was time. With each wave of pain, I tried to ignore the fact that I'd be having this baby without the without my family to help me, without the familiarity of home. When Jesus was finally born, I forgot all that, though. I wrapped him in cloths and made the most comfortable bed I could with the only thing we had, an animal's feeding trough. Joseph said I should have been sleeping then, but I couldn't stop staring at him. There he was, the one the angel had told me about. My heart was so full, but none of my words were big enough to express it. I know I wasn't the first young mother to bring a child into this world. It's always been that way. But as I looked down at my son, my Redeemer, I knew he was the one who would change everything. Because he had already changed me.
Celebrate. It was the longest, most difficult, scariest, exciting, confusing, and most wonderful day of my life. When you realize that God has allowed you to become a father, there's nothing that compares to it. And when it seems that he's deemed you worthy to be the stepfather to his son, now that's a bit overwhelming. He was born a perfectly healthy, happy baby boy. I guess just like any other baby. And I can understand why they call it labor. I've worked every day since I was 12 years old, and not once did I ever work as hard as Mary did that night. And Mary, she was amazing. Through all of it, not just the birth, but the months of people talking behind our backs, the week-long journey to Bethlehem. And then at the end of that, I watched as she turned a feeding trough of all things into a cradle, and it didn't faze her. She was incredible. And through it all, she never asked why. She just did exactly as God asked. She knew that even if she didn't understand what was going on, that God was in control. She was open to his will. And I can understand why he chose her. The thing I can't understand is why he chose me.
He was her man, she was his wife. And late one winter night, he knelt by her as she gave birth. But it wasn't his child. It wasn't his child. Yet still he took him as his own. And as he watched him grow, it brought him joy. He loved that boy, but it wasn't his child. It wasn't his child. And like a father, he was strong and kind. And I believe he did his best. It wasn't easy for him, but he did all he could. But his son was different from the rest. It wasn't his child. It wasn't his child. And when the boy became a man, he took his father's hand, and soon the world would all know why. It wasn't his child. It wasn't his child. And like his father, he was strong and kind and good. And I believe he did his best. It wasn't easy for him, but he did all he could. He grew up with his hands in wood. And he died with his hands. bones and wood. He was God's child. He was God's child. He was her man. She was his wife. And late one winter night, he knelt by her as she gave birth. But it wasn't his child. He was God's child.
Had I known then what I know now, there would have been room in my inn. Oy vey, pardon my French. I would have given up my own bed for them, but I didn't know. How could I? This place was packed. I'd never seen so many people in Bethlehem. The government made everyone in the world go back to their hometown and register. Government's got to get their money, right? Since nobody wants to stay with their in-laws, I'm booked solid. I remember that day well. The space we had was all taken up before dinner time. It was probably about 2 hours after dinner when they showed up. Talk about desperate. He was scared and exhausted, and she was about to burst. As they're walking up to me, I'm planning what I'll say in my head. I'm thinking, I'll say, "So sorry, we have no room left." But when they get to me, they just stand there for a minute. He looks down and tries to gather his thoughts. She winces in pain. Then he looks at me and says, "Please." That's all he says, is "Please." Let me tell you a story. I'm 5 years old, and I'm helping my mom set the table. I tell her that she has too many plates out. She looks at me and says, "You always make room." I look at her like, "What?" And she says empathetically, "You always make room. You never know who God may bring, and so you must always make room." So I look at the pregnant man and his wife, and her husband. I don't know where we'll make room, but we will. And so we made room. It wasn't the best room, but it was all we had to give them. So Mom was right. You always make room, especially when it comes to God.
Glorious song of It started out just as any other night, except for that angel. Ain't seen nothing like it before or since. The shepherds don't get a lot of excitement. That angel came right up to us, so bright, so beautiful. Now I know what you're thinking. Sam, you've been out in the pasture a little too long. And I had the exact same thought until the angel started talking. Don't be afraid, it said. And I shouted right back at him, too late. And then the angel said, bread, milk, Oh, that's my grocery list. Here we go. And the angel said, I have good news of great joy for all people. For unto you is born this day Christ the Lord in the city of David. Then said, he's laying in a manger, wrapped in cloth. Now go and find him. Okie dokie. One of the other shepherds said, what are you waiting for? Let's get out of here and get to Bethlehem. So I hightailed out of there and found that beautiful baby. I was a different man after that night because God chose me. In my entire life, no one had ever chose me. I'll never forget what that angel said. Good news to all people. That meant me too.
God had been silent for over 400 years. We knew because we had been listening, in a sense. My job was to listen. People who talk a lot, you don't call them wise, do you? No. There are a lot of other names that we have for them, and wise is not one of them. In my position, I looked for signs everywhere. We watched the stars, we watched them, and tried to interpret what they were telling us. I heard of a star that would announce a new king, and then out of nowhere, a star appeared. The star was different. It was a beacon in the night. After watching it for a while, it felt this was the star the Jews had been looking for, the star foretold in their ancient scripture, the star of the Messiah. So I followed it. There are a few of us, and yes, we actually followed a star. It was so bizarre. The star led us, it moved, and we followed, and eventually it led us to Jerusalem. That's where we met Herod. He claimed he also wanted to worship the new king. So he asked us. No, he demanded that once we found the newborn, we would come back and tell him. But we were warned in a dream not to trust this man. For over 2 years, we journeyed with the star guiding us all the way to Judea. And then it stopped, shining down over a small cottage. our journey ended not at a palace fit for a king, but at a home of a peasant. This was it. We gathered our thoughts, our gifts, and did what we could do to contain our emotions. And behind those doors, we found a new king, a king who commands the movement of the stars of the sky, and yet came to living among his people. And God was finished being silent. He spoke, and his word became flesh to dwell with his people. We knelt down that night. Yes, we kneeled before the baby boy, and each of us laid gifts at his feet. We had to. 400 years of the silence broken by the cries of the new king. Yes, he spoke, and we worshiped.
Name forever. It's been a privilege worshiping our Lord Jesus Christ today through music. My heart has been stirred and moved because of his presence in this place. And today, as we celebrate this end of the service, I want you to stand and join together in singing with us praises to our holy God.
Angels, we have heard our hearts sweetly singing o'er the plains, and the mountains in reply echoing their joyous strains. Gloria in excelsis Deo.
Hosanna in excelsis.